Just a couple of quick tips about if you're activating Windows on your new desktop. For example, like I had just upgraded my motherboard and CPU and memory and also my hard drive. And your best bet if you're upgrading to a new motherboard that has a trusted platform module or TPM would be to link your product key to your Microsoft account, so that you can go into your Microsoft account, which I'll show you in a few seconds, and take devices that have been previously registered, like your old hardware will be registered in a list, and remove it. And it does say you can activate the same product key with 10 different devices, but I don't know if that's exactly true. So don't take my word for that. But I had my previous Windows 10 with the old motherboard listed under registered devices, and then once I activated this, it was also shown under registered devices. And the problem doing it the way that Microsoft suggests in their frequently asked questions, which would be to install Windows and then activate it using their server, just going to troubleshoot activation and then activating it through their server, was immediately I was given a server error. So one luck I had the physical key saved to a notepad and put that in, and as you can see, my Windows is active. And like I mentioned earlier, here is the Microsoft account. In order to get to that, you can sign in through Outlook or live.com or whatever. And what you do is you go up to the upper right-hand corner and you click on that, and then you click My Microsoft Account to get where I am now. And as you can see, I have one device registered. And here's the system details. And as you can see, I have Windows 11 Professional, and it's the 2009 version, which is kind of weird. But anyway, and then system product name, I didn't type in what kind of system, and then it's a system serial number. So now when you upgrade your hardware, all you have to do is go in and either use the physical key or try to use the troubleshoot activation in Windows 11 and use the server to activate your product from Microsoft. And as you can see up here, you can remove this device and unlink it from your account, or you can actually find your device. Since mine is a desktop, I shouldn't need to find it. That's more for mobile devices and than it is for a desktop computer. If you have any questions about activating your Windows product, leave a comment below and I'll try my best to help you solve the problem. Subscribe or visit my YouTube channel.